My name's Jeb. Here's my plants from last year. I grew them the easy way. I'm gonna show you how I do it.
So close. Oh, that's smart. We need to turn it into a 3-inch hole. You want to see how?
Put your drill in reverse. Oops. We need something to hold the plant in the lid. This net cup should work once we wash it with bleach. Rinse off the bleach and add some media for the seeds to get started in. The lid's painted white to help reduce algae growth.
We have a pumpkin stain there?
Yeah. What do you think? Does that sound like a good idea?
No.
Kids these days. Pumpkins are large plants, so there's only room for one. But we put extra seeds in, just in case. Details on these nutrients are in the description. Use whatever's readily available for you, as long as it's made for hydroponics. I don't check the solution for concentration or pH. Just start out slow with your dosing, like what you'd use for seedlings or lettuce.
You're busted.
Just getting the pumpkins to grow.
I'm gonna do my best not to disturb the neighboring plant's roots. I'll give this one a chance in the soil. Good luck with the dandelions, buddy. The best place to check for plant health is the new growth. Soil pumpkin hides behind the brown dog. A few days later, it was mysteriously uprooted. When the plant grows large, give it support. The shape of the plant needs to be controlled with trellising and selective pruning. I need an access hole for water and nutrients. This stick will tell me how much water's in there. When the new growth gets too light, add some more nutrients with your water. Bugs think of these giant leaves. plane can sure drink water now. Well, the pumpkin's covered in flowers now. There's lots of bees, too. Things are looking real good, but problems always start in these lower leaves. My problem is, none of the male flowers have opened yet. Female flowers that don't get pollinated are rejected by the plant. Here's one that did get pollinated. Amazing. These circular spots on the leaf are a sign of disease. Now that fruits are finally growing, I think the plant's ready for a real dose of nutrients. Always be careful in the heat. The plant transpires more and brings up more nutrient water. It seems like powdery mildew is unavoidable in this climate. Preventative spraying might help. I'm just gonna cut out the worst leaves and hope for the best. With the fungus taking over, my focus is on getting this one pumpkin to maturity. So I'm gonna cut everything off that the plant doesn't need for that. Put too much nutrients in too. Here you can see the dark green new growth and tip burn. All I need to do for the water now is keep the level between here and here. Well, it doesn't weigh 100 pounds, but it's nice to see it turn orange.
Go get a pumpkin, come on!
The roots were invincible.